Okay children, in the previous video we started with the topic reproduction in plants and animals. We saw that reproduction is a process by which living organisms produce offsprings of their own kind. Okay, so here the new organism that is produced, it will be similar to the parent organism, right? Then we studied that there are two modes of reproduction, basically the asexual and sexual modes of reproduction. Okay, under asexual mode of reproduction in plants, we have studied that the plants reproduce asexually by spore formation, by fragmentation, and by vegetative propagation. We have already discussed the spore formation and fragmentation type of asexual reproduction in plants. Now we will start with the vegetative propagation. Okay, so what is vegetative propagation? Multiplication through vegetative parts of the plant, such as root, stem and leaves, is termed as vegetative propagation. Okay, so root, stem and leaves are called as vegetative parts of the plant. So when you produce new plant from these vegetative parts, then it is called as vegetative propagation. Understanding? These parts of vegetative propagation, they have buds present on them. Okay, they are called as vegetative buds. These vegetative buds will give rise to new plant. Suppose the stem is containing the vegetative bud, so from that vegetative bud a new plant can be produced, right? Yeah. Next thing is, once the plant is produced, then it will be removed from the parent plant and then it will be planted somewhere else so that it grows independently. Okay, examples of the plants like rose and strawberry are multiplied with the help of vegetative propagation method. Basically, vegetative propagation is of two methods. Okay, natural method and artificial method. Under natural method, the vegetative propagation takes place in nature, okay, with the help of the parts of root, stem and leaves. Whereas when we consider the artificial vegetative propagation, here human activity is involved. So human will be doing the vegetative propagation through the process of cutting, grafting and layering. So we are going to study these two types of, or you can say two methods of vegetative propagation in detail. Okay, to start with the natural one, the first one is the root. Okay, consider the tuberous root of the sweet potato. Okay, it is swollen as it stores the food material. Now, at the junction between the stem and the root, there are small buds present which are called as slips. Okay, these slips, they will grow and they will be forming new plant. Okay, you can detach the slips and plant it somewhere else so that an independent plant is grown. Okay, a new plant is grown. Understanding? So once again, the tuberous root of sweet potato, it stores the food and hence it is swollen. Okay, there are buds present at the junction between the shoot and the root. These buds are called as slips. Okay, these buds can grow into a new plant. So when you can just cut a piece of sweet potato, okay, and then plant it into the soil, so that new plant will be growing from those slips or those buds. Okay, yeah, so that is the vegetative propagation by roots. Next we come to vegetative propagation by stem. Okay, yeah, here if you consider the stem, one minute, yeah, here if you consider the stem, some plants will be propagating with the help of the subaerial stem and some plants will be propagating with the help of the underground stem. Okay, so under the underground stem, we are going to study about corms, rhizome, bulbs, tubers, all these different parts. Okay, one by one. So we will start with the subaerial stem. Okay, yeah, subaerial stem. Some plants have sub-aerial stem and these sub-aerial stems are called as runners. So here you can see these are the runners. Okay. The runners are found in the grass and in strawberry. So this particular strawberry runner you can see in the diagram. Okay. These stem, that is the runners, okay, they run horizontally along the ground. You can see this is the ground level and they are running horizontally along the ground. And they will be, wherever they touch, okay, they are having the nose. Suppose at this place they touch the ground, okay, they will be having the buds over here at the node, right? So what happens over here is, towards the lower side, that is in the soil, the roots will be prepared, produced, and towards the upper side, the shoot will be produced. Okay, understanding? Now, if you just cut the runner, okay, the new plant which is coming out, it will develop into an independent daughter plant. Okay, so what happens over here? See, in grasses and in strawberry, there are sub-aerial stem present which are called as runners. These stem are run horizontally or they grow horizontally along the ground. Okay, and they give rise to roots and shoots. Okay, at the nodes, the bud will be present. When the runner touches the ground, from the bud, the shoot will be coming out in the upward direction and the root will be growing in the soil. Okay, you can just cut the runner from there and a separate plant will develop. Okay, the daughter plant will develop. Understanding? So here the runner is touching the ground and from the bud that was present at the node, the shoot is coming out. So now if you cut it from here, this particular plant will be developing into a new daughter plant. Okay, and the examples we saw, it is grass and strawberry. Understanding? Yeah.